the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. And this is the day that we celebrate our beloved queen, Pastor Pamela Hines. DJ and I, or formerly Pastor DJ, and I have an incredible experience for each of you. We thank you here in the audience. We thank you here in our virtual audience. We've got an amazing lineup of guests, and we also have a surprise during this incredible evening.
Yes, we do. Let's give it up for Denise Thomas, who has taken her time, and she's helped us out so much with this as a host. Now, let's give it up for Denise. You look great tonight, D. Beautiful. You may leave with a Valentine's Day date.
Yes. Hold on, say it a little bit louder.
You might just leave with a Valentine's Day date.
Amen.
With that dress on.
And again, amen.
You look great. We are so excited. We've been working on this for quite a while now. We wanted to make sure that we could honor Pastor the best way we could because she's an amazing woman and she's done so many phenomenal things in her 60 years. You at home watching, we want you to make sure you share this stream. We want to make sure you like it. Tell somebody to log on now, otherwise they are going to miss out on an amazing evening. And it's so funny, as I started to think about my mother and some of her ways. Now, my mom has her ways. My mom has her ways, and she does things that aren't really normal, that I didn't think were normal. But I find out that they may be more close to how I am than I expected. For example, when my mom finds an outfit that she loves, she will wear it every single day. I'd be like, Mom, you wore that last time I saw you. She said, well, it fit and it's comfortable and I love it. Now I find myself in my going on 40 wearing the same thing every single day. I used to call my mom at 8 o'clock. Like, Mom, I called you last night at 8 o'clock. You didn't answer. Boy, you know I was asleep. I'm like, at 8 o'clock? You sleep at 8? Now I find myself at 8 o'clock going to bed. Mom, I'm more like you than I knew. I'll go out to eat with my mom. And she'll just pick around her food, won't eat her whole meal ever. I say, Mom, why don't you finish your food? She said, well, D, I can't eat a lot. I said, okay, well, I don't understand that, but okay, now I find myself picking around my plate. So, Mom, I want you to know that I'm a lot more like you, and you told me this was gonna happen. You said, just keep on living. Just keep on living. So we are gonna celebrate you tonight. We have some phenomenal plans. We have some wonderful people here. You give yourselves a hand for being here tonight. For those of you all who don't know, I think it's about at least 20 years ago, Bishop and Pastor Pam started a church in Waukegan, Illinois. I remember like it was yesterday. They used to take the drive to Waukegan early in the morning before our Milwaukee service would start. Bishop would preach, then drive back home. I think it was about an hour and 15 minutes and preach at our Milwaukee church. But God laid it on his heart to plant this couple that I'm going to present to you next to take over that church. And they've done a phenomenal job there in Waukegan. I want to present to you Bishop James and Pastor Deborah Logan from CFFC Zion. You all give them a big hand as they take the stage.
Well, oh, there she is. So I wasn't gonna come without her. Well, praise the Lord. Can I take my mask off and talk? Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Well, we've already thanked God for being here. And I guess we kind of thank the honoree, but can we just really do it really a little bit better this time? Let's just praise God for Pastor Pam. Come on, come on. This is her birthday celebration. Bless your heart, Pastor Pam. You are loved by many, 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 many people all over the world. We are here to just give some brief remarks, and we're going to pray a blessing. And so I'm gonna give you the mic.
God bless you, Bishop, Pastor Pam. It's such an honor and a privilege to be here to celebrate you. 60 years, I think we've been knowing you all for the last 30 of those years, and what an honor and a privilege it is to sit under your tutelage, to be blessed by your wisdom and your knowledge and how you apply the word and make it applicable to our lives in every genre and in every circumstance and situation that we've been through. I've seen how you all have cared and loved on people down through the years, and you have not waned. Your beauty is still beautiful. You don't look like what you've been through and what you've gone through and how you've helped heal the land here. I mean, I remember when we had a conference, Bishop, it was called the Lifting of the Curse. You all are still lifting curses over this region, over this county, over Milwaukee County. Corona 19, 20, and beyond don't have any place because of the wisdom, the heart, and the love of God that you have for God's people. We are here to celebrate you and your major, major accomplishments. We wouldn't be who we are in God without the awesome example that you have been down through the years. And guess what? Guess what, y'all? They haven't changed. You know, you can know somebody for 10 minutes and you go back and you look and you're just like, oh, okay, I don't recognize who they are. They have been consistent and a constant in our lives. The gospel ain't strange. It's not peculiar. We know that they, when they get the mic and they speak, they're talking about Jesus, the Christ, and his anointing. Nothing else. So I'm blessed by the life that you live, the children that you've raised, fine young men that are examples in our community. Our son wanted to be like them, serving their parents. What can we say? I'm still married to this handsome man of God because of the love that you displayed and showed as a wife. Not to browbeat my husband, not to overstep him or overshadow him. Okay. It's 60 years.
Okay. Thank you, honey. Listen, we're going to get out of the way, but I want to say this. The Lord dropped Galatians 6:6 in my heart. Because I was praying about this when I received the notification. And it simply says, let those that have been taught in the word communicate back. That word communicate has the koinonia. It's the love. It's the fellowship. It says communicate back to them that teach it in all good things. You have taught us. Pastor has said that. You have been an example for over 30 years in our life. Husband, wife, male, female, pastor, bishop, mother, I can check the list off. We are just here to communicate back to you part of what you mean to us. And it has been our prayer from day one that you would never have a day that you would be ashamed to call us your son and daughter in ministry. God bless you. Talk about, I'm trying to stop. You want me to, okay, she want me to talk about this. I was telling my wife, and then I'm going to get out of the way. I was telling my wife that you all have been like a buoy. Buoys are set out in lakes and oceans to help navigate the ships through and around rocks. You have been stable. Buoys don't move. They can't move. Because the ships would get in trouble. You have been buoys over the 30 years, we could look out and monitor which way to go, because you all have been consistent. You have been faithful. You taught me what holiness was. Okay, I'm going to stop. So come on, let's stop. So we're going to pray, because there's so much I can say about you all, and many others will. Bow your heads and let me just pray a blessing over this fine couple. And of course, it's Pastor Pam's birthday, but you can't celebrate Pastor Pam without Bishop Darrell. You just can't do that. And so let's bow our heads and let's just stretch our hands towards them. Let's just stretch our hands towards them. Father, in the name of your son, Jesus, you have raised them up. They have come through trials and tribulations. The enemy has tried to stop them and cancel their assignment so many times. But yet and still, they still remain faithful in all that they have encountered, in all that they have continued to do, to lift up the name of Jesus. You told him to tell a dying world about a living Christ. And Pastor Pamela Megan Hines has joined him in that assignment, in that purpose, and in that destiny. And we pray a blessing over them, even tonight as she celebrates a big milestone of living, God. Let this be a night to remember. Cause them to be blessed beyond measure. We speak health. We speak wealth. We speak prosperity. We speak wisdom over them. Give them the insight they need for the people they feed in this last evil day, Father. We need to hear from true men and women of God that have stood the test of time. So, Father, we bless them. We thank you for them. We speak well of them, and we know that you love them. And may they experience, and may they know tonight some of the love that the people of God have for them. In Jesus' name, amen. Somebody shout amen. Thank you. Bless you.
Amen. Thank you so much, Bishop James and Pastor Deborah. Are we having a good time? We are just getting started as we continue celebrating our beloved queen, Pastor Pamela Hines. Romans 12, verse 10. Be devoted to one another in love and honor one another above yourselves. And that is exactly what we want to do tonight. I know many of you here in the audience, and by the way, y'all look real, real royal right now. Real royal. Thank you so much. And for those in our virtual audience, I know many of you are thinking, how can I present Pastor Pam with a token of my love or our love or appreciation? So tonight, pay attention to the screen, because we are going to be showing you how you can give and honor Pastor Pamela Hines tonight. Now this morning, Bishop Hines talked about Cash App. And I called DJ and I said, Bishop said we don't do Cash App, we do Blessed App. So can we call the folks at Cash App and get that changed? So we're working on that. But in the meantime, please make sure that, again, you pay attention to the information presented on the screen and send some love, send a blessing to our very own Pastor Pamela Hines. Now, before we get started rolling with our incredible, incredible videos, I just want to say a prayer really quick. Father, we thank you for allowing us to be together in celebration of our queen, Pastor Pam. And I just want to thank you in advance that as I age, I will age and look just like Pastor Pam. Everyone, enjoy. Let's get this celebration started.
Pamela Megan Hines was born February 13, 1961 in Memphis, Tennessee. Her mother, Hazel, moved to Milwaukee, Wisconsin, where she and her two sisters, Lavender and Ruby, would be raised. Pamela attended Jackie Robinson Middle School and Mesmer High School. As the oldest of three girls, Pamela's influence would begin at an early age.
The question I always get is, what was it like growing up with Pastor Pam? It's not often that people are able to say that their own sister or even their brother is their role model. Growing up with Pastor Pam, or the person that you even know today, she was the same then as she is today. She has always been the most amazing, hardworking person I have ever met. Growing up, our mother, she was a very hard worker. But I even think at this point, Pastor Pam has surpassed our own mother in her ability to outwork all of us. So I would say it's kind of like keeping up with the fastest person in a foot race. Pastor Pam is full of grit. And if anyone is looking for any sort of formula for success, just watch her. Watch her in action. She doesn't back down. She operates with love and compassion, and she's been that way since we were young. But you also don't want to cross her. If I remember correctly from when we were younger, there was a time when a neighbor friend did something to one of us siblings, and all of a sudden, I saw Pastor Pam take out of our house, down the street, to the neighbor's house. I'm not exactly sure what happened, but I can guarantee you, they never mess with any of us ever again. Pastor Pam is amazing. I love the fact that she is my sister. I love the fact that I can turn to her in my time of need and that she can give such beautiful wisdom that not just comes from her experience of 60 years of living, but also from the fact that she's a godly woman. Everyone needs a Pastor Pam in their life, and I'm so grateful. Happy birthday, Pam.
Fairy tale beginnings and happy endings would reign true in the story of how Pamela met Daryl. Pamela's family attended church regularly. One day, while visiting the Greater West Side Church of God in Christ, Pamela laid her eyes on one of the musicians. She compares her reaction to seeing him to the way Diana Ross' character did to Billy Dee Williams in Lady Sings the Blues. So it was with Pamela when she saw Daryl Lynn Hines.
When I first met Pam, she was 12 years old. She lived down the street from some members at my father's church. My father was my pastor, and so she moved down the street from the Rouse family, and they brought her to church, Greater West Side Church of God in Christ, on 33rd and St. Paul. And so when I saw Pam come in the room, she was just beautiful. She was just beautiful. I was sitting on the organ playing the organ for my dad's service. And so I kept my eyes on her because she was more pretty than anyone that I had seen up until that point in my life. And so she got happy. I didn't know she came from a Baptist church. So when she was a girl, she went to the Baptist church. So when she got happy, she started screaming real loud and got real stiff. Now you gotta understand, in the Church of God in Christ, first of all, back then we didn't think Baptist people could be saved. And anything that wasn't quite like we were could be borderline demon possessed. And so, you know, with her screaming and getting stiff, you know, I was like, you know, I don't think I can like her because she doesn't praise God quite the way we do. I almost let the devil trick me out of my wife because of the way she praised God. Screaming and getting stiff, you know, she was probably one good congregational song from getting the devil cast out of her. That's how we rolled back then. But that's how I met her.
40 years later, Daryl and Pamela are still happily married and stronger than ever. Pamela found her purpose while pursuing her passion to be Daryl's wife. She reveals how through prayer, love, and determination, she has weathered storms, stood firm on God's word for marriage, and has lived to see the fruit and blessings of doing it God's way. Pastor Pam is excited to tell her full story in her new book, The Purpose-Driven Wife, to be released in summer 2021.
Happy birthday, beautiful Lady Pamela. I was so excited when I was asked to be a part of celebrating you. Actually, I've been reflecting on the first time I met you, and I have met some amazing people with my husband, but you have left an amazing impression upon my heart. I remember you were being so beautiful, so poised, and so kind, and although beautiful on the outside, even more stunning on the inside. You were wearing this pink St. John suit, and within 2 weeks, I received that pink St. John suit in the mail. I was floored because I had never had anyone so gift me so lavishly upon meeting me for the first time. And what it has taught me over the years is to not hold on to things so tightly and to be a blessing and give when I feel led. You've been an amazing part of my life, even though I don't see you very much. I still pray those amazing prayers over my husband. And what you've taught me, I think more than anything, is that there is power in being soft and in being feminine and in being authentically myself. And so I celebrate you today, and I am honored to do so. I want to be just like you when I grow up. I'm one of your biggest fans. Happy birthday.
Hello, Pastor Pam. Irvin and I would like to wish you a happy birthday. We love you, and you know, you are such an amazing, phenomenal woman, someone that I always look up to. You're doing such amazing things, you know, in the world with your church and with other things. And it just makes all of us women out here feel proud to know you and to try to emulate you. So I wish you a beautiful birthday. I hope you enjoy your day, and we love you. Mwah.
Well, Pastor Pam, keep doing what you're doing. You're the first lady of your incredible church. You're the first lady of Milwaukee, the first lady of Wisconsin, and then the first lady of the church in God in Christ. You are just a Christian woman, a woman of God. And thank you for blessing not only women, but blessing everybody. And also, I love you and the bishop. Man, you guys can dress. I mean, y'all always sharp, looking good. You know, Cookie and I try to be like you too. That's right. Representing in the highest level. So God bless you. You got a beautiful family, and it starts with you. And we love you. Happy birthday. And may God continue to bless you and your family and keep touching people's lives and saving people's lives. Thank you. Happy birthday.
Hello. Oh, there you go. What an honor it is to stand before you today to wish you a happy birthday. And what I do privately all the time, I'll stand here publicly and say, I love you so, so, so much. DJ came to me not long ago and he told me some things that God has showed him in prayer. And he talked about a scripture in James that talked about how you can be perfect. You can be perfect in the eyes of God. Of course, not to the world, but in the eyes of God, you can be perfect. And so he mentioned that, and I'll paraphrase the scripture. It just kind of says, if you can control your mouth, then you can be perfect in God's eyes. And in turn, you can, controlling your mouth can and make you control your whole body. So controlling your mouth then in turn helps you control your whole body. So the first person I thought of was you. I've never heard you say one ill word about anybody. You're always very gracious and sweet and kind. So you are perfect. I also want to say before I start crying, I want to say I gleam at you daily, and I'm so honored to be a part of the Fantastic Four, which is myself, Ashley, DJ, and Brandon. We get to experience you. when you put that mom hat on, and it's just a few of us, just us four, that can say that. So I appreciate you, and it is an experience, and it's an experience to see you show what a mom is, and how do you be a mom to two grown men with wives and children. It is truly an experience. So if I can just take a little bit of that while I'm raising my children, they're going to be okay. So I just want to say happy birthday. I love you. I glean from you your poise, your wisdom, your kind words. You always make me feel good. So I love you so much. Happy birthday. And I'll introduce my son, Daryl Hines III, and he'll speak on behalf of the grandchildren, which is himself, Chloe, Deuce, Sedona, and Cora.
Hi. I am going to speak on behalf of the grandkids, and we love you, and we think you're a great grandma, and you will always be that for our life, and you are a great role model. You are a great example. And you keep your word, and we can learn from you. I said that three times. And happy birthday.
Excellent. Great job, nephew. Mom, happy 60th birthday. I'm so thrilled to celebrate you. I have known you at this point in my life more than I haven't. And so you have been, I would say you've touched every aspect of who I am so many ways. So obviously as a spiritual leader, as a pastor first, and I would say being under your leadership, I grew so much. Watching you embody faith and really like take it from theory to practice has been so amazing. And I would say as, of course, a community leader, you give so much of your heart to people. And as an entrepreneur, I've been able to glean so much from you. And then of course, as a mother and a wife, which is just amazing. Like Nina said, getting to see you raise the boys and how that transitions to adulthood. Getting to see you be a wife, because daddy, you're not the easiest. I love you though. mom's level of patience, like Nina said, you don't say anything. I'm like, mom, you just, your graciousness is like none other. And I aspire to that. And you're absolutely beautiful, mom. I mean, I posted you yesterday and my friends were like, 60? Where? How? And I'm like, I don't know. But you are absolutely beautiful inside and out. I'm blessed to know you like I do. Happy 60th. Love you, mom.
One of the most remarkable jobs Pamela Hines has ever embraced in her life is that of a mother. 2 years after Daryl and Pamela married on November 14th, 1981, they would have their firstborn son, namesake of her husband, Daryl. Daryl Lynn Hines II, who they'd call DJ. 2.5 years later, she gave birth to their second son, Brandon Lynn Hines. Though she was called to ministry with her husband, she never let her responsibility as mother fall short. She was adamant about being present and ensuring her sons were given the attention, love, support, and guidance they needed each and every day.
Hello and good evening. I'm DJ.
And I'm Brandon.
And we just want to tell you that our mother is such a phenomenal woman for so many reasons that we can't cover tonight. We don't have enough time. But there are three things I can say about my mom. First of all, she is one of the most consistent people that I know. I always know what to expect from my mother. And that is sweet kindness every time. That's the second thing I can say about my mother. She is probably one of the sweetest, most kindest women that I've ever met. Like, and it's not just like around people and when she's around church. That follows her everywhere she goes. She's sweet and kind to everyone she comes in contact with. And that could be at the grocery store. You all get the point. She is a beautiful woman inside and out. And lastly, the thing that probably would stand out most about my mom is just her pure love for God. You know, she is a true woman of God who prays, who fasts, who intercedes for people. She's just a true woman of God, and you know, it shows in her life. So, you know, I could say a whole lot, but I'll just stop there and let my brother say something.
Yeah, I totally agree with you, DJ. I totally agree. My mom is, she's an example, not just for women, but she's an example for all of us as to really what the character of Christ looks like. And the thing that I love the most about my mom is that what you see is the true her. She's genuine. You know, she's genuinely loving and kind and compassionate, and she genuinely loves God. And so what you see is the true, real Pastor Pam. And so, Mom, we celebrate you and we love you.
And I just want to thank you. I can't thank you enough for passing on all of your good genes to me. Thank you. I appreciate that. Brandon, I'm sorry. Thank you. No, happy birthday, Mom. We love you so much, and we hope that you have an amazing 60th birthday.
Happy birthday, Mom. We love you.
Good evening, everybody. Good evening. My name is Melva Henderson, and I had to write down what I wanted to say because I didn't want to cry and I didn't want to forget. And, you know, I walked through the doors of Christian Faith Fellowship in June of 1989 when the church wasn't yet 6 months old. From the moment I walked through the doors, I knew that my life would never be the same. There were two main things that I encountered that have shaped me into the woman that I am today. One was a man, namely our bishop, Bishop Daryl Hines, who was so focused on the purpose of God to tell a dying world about a living Christ that that purpose became my own. And then the second encounter that I had was this quiet, fierce, 5'2", size 6.5, shoe-wearing, dress size 4, having African-American woman named Pamela Megan Hines, whom we affectionately call Pastor Pam. Pastor Pam was my first encounter with an African-American female pastor, and I can say with the greatest conviction that her posture as a woman in ministry and position as the co-pastor of this church was a game changer for our city, for our culture, and for my life personally. Thousands, and I do mean thousands of women globally, have come on the scene following the path that she paved. And not only female pastors and co-pastors, but female evangelists, missionaries, apostles, prophets, and I dare not mention the female entrepreneurs and women in business. Through her books, Women of Excellence series, Image Course, Wife School courses, and exemplary teaching from the pulpit, Pastor Pam has and continues to teach us how to care for ourselves, our homes, our husbands, our children, all while maintaining our God-given position within the kingdom of God. Pastor Pam encouraged us to show up in the world unapologetic, authentic, and being the best version of ourselves that we could be. Pastor Pamela Hines moved into this space at a time when women serving in leadership roles within the church was frowned upon in many circles. And she may not realize this, but God chose her to leverage his plan to advance women in leadership within the church At the same time, he was advancing women in the marketplace, making them CEOs, vice presidents, and presidents. So God used her and continues to do so, showing women like me and others all over the world that you can be powerful and still be pretty. That you don't have to act like a man, talk like a man, walk like a man, or think like a man to be used of God. Pastor Pam, today, I stand here to say thank you. I represent every woman who rooted for you, followed you, prayed for you, watched you, and recognized that through you, God was giving all of us the thumbs up to step into our place as women. Women called, women set apart for his purpose and for his glory. Women who will reach every nation, every tribe, and every tongue. Pastor Pamela Megan Hines, please know that every woman in ministry or business in this place is eternally grateful that you said yes to the plan of God for your life, because your yes gave yes to our yes. God bless you, Pastor Pam. I love you. I love you. And I can honestly say that I don't know that there's any woman in the world, and my husband will tell you, that I adore the way that I adore you. When I say that I am who I am because you are who you are, that is the absolute truth. God bless you, and happy 60th birthday.
Pamela Hines, a devoted wife and mother, always committed herself to helping her husband become everything God called him to be. While evangelizing across the country, Daryl called home and told Pamela, "It's time for us to start a church." Pamela immediately went to the Yellow Pages to begin searching for a building. In June of 1989, Christian Faith Fellowship Church would be established. Step-by-step purpose would begin to unfold for Pastor Pam. She started out as the first children's pastor, and with her strong desire to connect with and see women at their best, the first department she developed was the women's ministry. The first fellowship was called Chat and Chew. Throughout the years, she was graced by God to meet so many women who have been inspired and blessed through her leading and influence.
It has been truly a blessing to have been chosen by Pastor Pam to assist her sharing healthy, lifestyle-changing information during the Chat and Chews, the Image courses, and the Women of Excellence ministry. Pastor Pam is such an inspiration. Not only has she transformed individual women's lives, but entire families and communities. Pastor Pam has impacted my life in such a powerful way. After moving to Florida, I continued Pastor Pam's vision and started a ministry, the Academy of Image and Etiquette, educating men, women, and children. If someone asked me to describe Pastor Pam in a few short words, I would have to say she is a very wise woman, beautiful inside and out, anointed, and an effectual, fervent prayer warrior. Pastor Pam was created by God for a purpose, an example for all. Pastor Pam, I am so honored to celebrate you on your 60th birthday. Thank you. I love you. May God continue to bless you. Happy birthday.
Her desire to pray out God's will for her marriage was the foundation of her first book, A Wife's Prayer, which is filled with scripture-based prayers a wife can pray for her husband concerning every area of his life. From the principles found in Titus 2, she also created Wife School, a course she designed to give women understanding and clarity of what it means to be a wife. She launched the Fabric of a Woman conference, named after her book, The Fabric of a Woman. She'd go on to create the Expect Amazing Women conference, ministering to the mind, body, and soul. She not only has a heart for adult women, but women of all ages. One program she holds dear is Covenant Girls, a program designed to empower and enrich the lives of the girls ages 8 to 18. Coming to the stage live is Covenant Girl alumni, Kateri Bluford.
Hey, hi. Listen, y'all, I've had to keep this secret for like 2 weeks. I've talked to her every day. I told her, I said, you know, I got another gig, so I won't be there. Not knowing it was yours. It was yours. I love you so much. I've learned so much from you. You've taught me how to be a woman. You've taught me how to just walk with grace, give people grace. You've shown me the beauty in myself. And I'm standing here as a reflection of your wisdom, of your guidance, of your love, of your compassion. And I am now a grown woman, and I've learned from Covenant Girls that you can be strong, courageous, powerful, but still soft. And we learned that from you. So I am a product of that. And I'm just gonna sing a little bit. I'm just gonna serenade you and just kind of let you know who you really are. Exposed, and I can't hide no more. I can't hide as the sun shines on all of my glory, and my flaws don't look so bad at all. And what was I so afraid of? That every part of me is a vision of a portrait of Mona, of Mona Lisa. Every part of me is beautiful, and I finally see I am a work of art, I am a masterpiece. Oh, 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 oh. Who is this I tried so long to find? Filling my head with lies that I'm not good enough, and I heard something in my ear tell me I'm perfect. And now that I know the truth, now it's time to show and prove that every part of me is a vision of a portrait of Mona, of Mona Lisa. That every part of me is beautiful, and I finally see that I am a work of art, a masterpiece. Oh, 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 oh. And now I see the print colors on my canvas. I'm a work of art, a Mona Lisa. I show my picture of the world. I'm not afraid to let it show anymore. I can light the night, and I shine so bright. I shine so bright, 'cause I am Mona Lisa. Colors paint the sky. There is beauty in my eyes. I'm Mona Lisa. Oh, it took a while to see it now. I'm so glad I can see it now. 'Cause I am a work of art. I am Mona Lisa. Every part of me. Vision, a portrait of Mona, a Mona Lisa. Every part of me is beautiful, and I now finally see that I am a work of art. I am a masterpiece.
Hi, this is Pastor Demoria Sherman, and I'd like to wish one of the sweetest ladies I know a happy 60th birthday. Pastor Pam, you are the epitome of elegance, style, and grace. I have known you for over 30 years, and I believe that last year, 2020, was the first year in that time that I have not stayed in your home. And I have had the privilege of experiencing God in your life, not just at church, but even in your home. You are an awesome wife, mother, grandmother, sister, and friend. And from myself, my wife, my sons, and our church family, we want to wish you a very happy birthday. God bless.
Happy birthday, Pastor Pam Hines. What a blessing it is to join all of those that are taking this opportunity to celebrate you on this very important day. Now, they told me what birthday it was, but they didn't tell me that I should say so. So, you know, as a gentleman, I'm not going to articulate which birthday it is, although I know you're not ashamed. I'm just not gonna be the one. On behalf of Lady Priscilla, Seth, myself, the whole McClendon family, we wanna just thank God for you. I know what a blessing you are to God's people, what a blessing you have been over the years to my brother, Bishop Hines. He sings your praises as well he should. Once again, we love you, we appreciate you, and thank God for you on your birthday. Happy birthday to you.
All right, DJ. So before we introduce our next guest, I just have to say again, Pastor Pam, we love you so much. We thank God for you. And for those, again, in our virtual audience, please continue to like this event, show your love, share it, because so many people around the world love and adore Pastor Pam, and we want to make sure they have an opportunity to share in this celebration tonight.
Yes, Denise, thank you so much. And, you know, we've seen a little bit of Pastor Pam's life, her being a mother, her being a pastor, being a wife. And, you know, in order to do all that she does, you have to have a sense of humor. And anybody that knows Pastor Pam knows that she enjoys laughing. I know probably 9 times out of 10 when we're on the phone together, we will end the call laughing about something. So she takes her time and finds time to laugh. And because we know you enjoy laughing, we had one of your good friends stop by to make you laugh.
Hey, 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 what's up? Happy birthday, Pastor Pam. What up, Bishop? To Christian Faith Church. Yes, I am here, comedian Marcus D. Wiley. And I know some of you saying, what is he doing at our church on our stage in these COVID streets? Well, to answer that question, I have bills. Yes, my bills are not on a pandemic. Matter of fact, they've gotten more aggressive during the pandemic. They showing up at my house, my bills, not even wearing a mask. They don't even put them in the envelope no more. They just kind of showing up. I have so many bills now, I don't even call them bills. Bills is a nickname. I call them by their real name, which is William, okay? Yeah, once you start paying mortgages and multiple car notes, they are no longer bills. Those are Williams. And so that's why I am here to help you, Pastor Pam, celebrate 60 years. Come on now, 60 years. Now, DJ did not tell me this was a black tie event. I mean, he put it on the screen. But he ain't let me know it was a black tie event. You know, I got a black tie and a black mask. I could have came here looking real fly. Nevertheless, Pastor Pam, what have you been doing during this pandemic? I can only imagine that you no longer straightening up, you cleaning up. Yeah, see, young girls, they straighten up. Seasoned women clean up. Straightening up is when you're doing stuff like Febreze in the place and fluffing the pillows. You know, cleaning up is when you washing the baseboards, you know. Cleaning up is when you got the vacuum lines in the carpet. Cleaning up is when you get a wet rag and get all that dust off that ceiling fan. And I know you've been doing that during this pandemic. Pastor Pam, have you been fixing or have you been cooking? Because you do know cooking and fixing are two different things. See, them young girls, they fix. You know, fixing, you fix stuff like tuna fish. You fix stuff like hamburger helper. You fix salad. Okay, you fix popcorn. And believe it or not, you fix tacos. A lot of brothers out there, you thinking your girl, ooh, she cooking tacos tonight. No, sir, that's fixing, okay? Taco Tuesday, you getting all excited about a fixed meal. Cooking, Pastor Pam, for the season, women. Cooking is when you stuff something. It's when you smother something. It's when you saute something. It's when you preheat the oven on 350 for 2 weeks. That's cooking, okay? That's cooking. As a matter of fact, I remember when me and my wife, we bought our first home, and we were at the design center, and my wife, she ran into this little old demo, this little kitchen, right? And so she's like, babe, that's the kitchen I want. And I was like, okay. So I went to the white lady, because that's what it was. I went to the white lady. I said, excuse me, ma'am, my wife loved this kitchen. How much is the kitchen? The white lady shares with me that this kitchen right here is $60,000. I said, $60,000? I said, ooh, I went to my wife. I said, babe, I don't think we're going to be able to get that kitchen at $60,000. She said, but babe, that's the kitchen I really want. I said, but babe, you don't have enough meals in your repertoire for a $60,000 kitchen. I mean, matter of fact, you ain't even cooking there. All you do is wash your hair. When did the kitchen become a salon? Okay, all you're doing is washing your hair now, babe. I said, no. As a matter of fact, I went to the white lady. I said, look, man, we don't need a $60,000 kitchen. Do y'all sell concession stands? Because that's what we need, okay? Because that's what she good at. She good at Frito pies and Twizzlers and pickles and all that old good stuff. But nevertheless, listen, I stopped by Pastor Pam because I wanted to share with you that I know you're looking phenomenal. I know you're doing your thing. I already know Bishop and the church was not going to let this corona, COVID-19, be a Red Sea for them to stop celebrating you and all your greatness. So happy birthday, many, many more. Love you, and I'll see you in person at the proper time. Peace.
I can't help but and I'll be there in a hurry. Yeah. I don't care who's left you before. I'm here, and you don't have to worry anymore.
Pastor Pam, welcome to the 6 days, yeah. Ooh, welcome to the 6 days. Happy birthday, young lady. Now, people get all upset about aging and maturing. Let me tell you something about 60, as one who's been here for 2 years. This is the best place to be. Your life has always been great, and it's been good, but it's about to get gooder. Mm-hmm. Tell you what I know. It only gets better. I was thinking about this the other day when DJ hit me up and said that they were doing video shout outs. I said I had to participate because the first time I met you and Bishop Daryl, I just felt like I knew y'all from way back. You know, like I imagined it in my head. Me and Daryl and you in the same high school, you know, in the 70s. Me and Daryl played on the basketball squad, starting lineup. You know, he probably stepped to you because you were the head cheerleader. And Daryl stepped to you with his thick mustache in the 12th grade. He's like, you know, smooth, got you. Y'all got married, beautiful family, beautiful life. And you're still here at 60. Mm-hmm. God is good. Actually, he's more than good. He's way above that. So I'm here to celebrate with you. Have yourself a good time today, Pastor P. I wish I could be there, but you know, trumped it. Not COVID, trumped it. Got us locked down, but enjoy your day. In my spirit, all up in my soul, I'm sending you two pairs of Louboutins and a Gucci bag. In my spirit, but in my reality, that's best I can do. A little long distance chocolate kiss on the cheek. Happy birthday, I love you. What's up, Bishop Daryl? Can't wait to see y'all again soon. Take care, God bless.
Good evening, everyone. Oh my God, I love you so much. I'm so honored to be here to celebrate you, Pastor Pam. And hello, Bishop, how are you? I'm gonna tell you, you're the only one I come out for. This is the second event I've been out for. The first one was to celebrate you as Woman of Influence. This is the second, and it's your birthday. So I love you, and I have a few words that I'm gonna share from my heart. You know, I'm here to introduce the segment of you as a community leader. You know, we've done a lot together over 21 years. You've been so inspirational to me as a leader, as a wife, and as a mother. I'm a different person because of you. And so I took the liberty of looking up your name. After 21 years, you know what your name Pamela means? All sweetness. And I said, of course, of course. All they needed was your picture right there in the dictionary. And so there are a few words that came to mind as I looked up each letter of your name. P, pure of heart, honest in all of your business efforts. Perfect peace is what you always bring to the table. You're an amazing leader that exudes skill and creativity and stamina like none other. You're a mogul. You're the co-founder of multiple schools and businesses and a best-selling author. I know you don't like to talk a lot about yourself, and you and I have had this conversation, so you know I'm letting it rip tonight for you. E, you are elegant, yet both powerful and empowering to all women entrepreneurs. L, loving kindness are your trademarks. You cannot be copyrighted, ever. Of course, you're a godly woman that is A, adored by all, and especially me. So to you, Pastor Pamela Hines, the entrepreneur, the woman of influence, the community leader, I salute you on today. Every woman salutes you on today. Happy 60th birthday. I love you.
Pastor Pam's influence has been great in the kingdom of God and those she and her husband pastor. However, her reach extends beyond the four walls of the church. Pamela advocates for the lives and well-being of those in the community as an ambassador for the Blood Centers of Wisconsin, a partner with LLS, where she is a forerunner for Light the Night Walk.
Pastor Pam, look at all the lives that you have touched in your 60 years. I sure hope you're feeling the love. All of us at LLS are grateful for your personal leadership in the fight against cancer, and we're proud of our partnership with all of our friends at Christian Faith Fellowship Church through Light the Night. Your impact is truly saving lives.
Having had several family members affected by breast cancer, she has hosted the Breast Cancer Walk during her Expect Amazing Women's Conference and hosts a yearly Pink Sunday service to honor those affected by and still in the fight against breast cancer. Her belief in sowing into the future of our youth through education is phenomenal. Each year, the Karina Hines Scholarship is given out to college students during her Expect Amazing Conference. She started the Hazel Westmoreland Backpack Giveaway in honor of her mother's commitment to give back to children in the community. Due to her consistent service and commitment to the lives of those in the community, she was recently given the honor of being named Woman of Influence by the Milwaukee Business Journal. Pastor Pam and her husband, Bishop Hines, strongly believe in the power of education and the impact education has in an individual's life. Soon after Christian Faith Fellowship Church built the 86th and Good Hope location, Daryl Lynn Hines Academy was founded by Bishop Hines and Pastor Pamela Hines and became the first international baccalaureate school in Wisconsin. Not many years later, Destiny High School would be established at the now Destiny Plaza campus.
We are so excited to have a leader like Pastor Pam. Why do I say that? It's because Pastor Pam exudes the spirit of excellence, love, caring spirit. And so as leaders in both schools, we have the opportunity to showcase that same spirit of love, excellence, and a caring spirit to our students. Pastor Pam's desire is to see students understand their full destiny, that they can achieve whatever they set their minds to. And it's because she has spoken that vision forth that we're able to implement that vision within our schools. One of the desires of Pastor Pam is to see young ladies achieve their goals, to see them empowered. And so we're able to tell young ladies, guess what? You can be and achieve whatever it is that you have the desire in your heart to achieve. And we are so grateful for you, Pastor Pam. We're thankful for the times you come into the halls and you take the time to greet our students and show them the love of God. And so because of that, we're able to continue seeing that vision implemented within our schools.
Hi, I'm Mayor Tom Barrett, and I want to wish a special hello to Bishop Daryl Hines and the entire Christian Faith Fellowship Church family. I am so honored to wish Pastor Pam a happy 60th birthday. Pastor Pam, you and Bishop Hines are the leaders of a great flock. 60 years young, and a great leader, a woman of influence, and a powerful impact on the entire city of Milwaukee. Pastor Pam, you have blessed so many lives through your faithful ministry. So on your special day, I want to express my appreciation for you and wish you many more happy moments in your life. May God's grace strengthen you as you mark your 60th birthday. And may God bless you and keep you always. Thank you for your service and congratulations on reaching this important milestone. Again, happy birthday, Pastor Pam, and happy Valentine's Day to everyone.
What a joy it is to celebrate the birthday of Lady Pamela Hines. Due to the pandemic, we're not able to be there with you and the family of believers at Christian Faith Fellowship Church. Lady May and I want to send our love to you and celebrate the gift that you are to the body of Christ. Over the years, we've all been able to admire all that you encompass as a woman of God, faithfully supporting your husband, Bishop Daryl Hines. You are a fantastic mother to your children, and you serve the people of God with class, integrity, and love. The Word of God tells us in Proverbs 31 and 11, the heart of her husband safely trusts her so that he will have no lack of gain. As a virtuous woman, you have not only won the trust of your husband, but of the many thousands that your ministry has touched. Please know that Lady May and I love and appreciate you And we pray that God continues to richly bless you with his best blessings today and throughout the rest of your beautiful life. Happy birthday.
Yes, yes. We are still having such an incredible time this evening in celebrating our beautiful queen. And I say that with the utmost sincerity, Pastor Pam. Now, I want to share some things, and DJ is probably already doing this, but I have to say this to you. Pastor Pamela Hines, you are a living testimony that as we continue to grow in strength in God, we are still able to bear even more. This comes to those such as you, Pastor Pam, that are seasoned wise souls whose roots are as strong as their branches. In Psalm 92, verse 12, the righteous will flourish like a palm tree. They will grow like a cedar in Lebanon, planted in the house of the Lord. They will flourish in the courts of our God. They will still bear fruit in older age. The Bible said old. I changed it to older. Forgive me, Lord. They will still stay fresh and green, proclaiming, "The Lord is upright. He is my rock, and there is no wickedness in him, such as there is no wickedness in our very own Pastor Pamela Hines." As we begin to close this evening in celebration, I want to thank Bishop Hines. I want to thank my brother, Pastor DJ, my beautiful sister, Nina, Pastor Brandon, my beautiful sister, Ashley, for allowing me to share this experience of honoring you, Pastor Pam. And please know that it had not been for you on April 26th of this year, I would not be standing here, because your sermon that day, along with Bishop Hines, gave me the encouragement that I needed to keep being the effective communication coach. God bless you. I love you so much, and thank you. Now, as we begin to close, thank you. As we begin to close this evening's celebration, as children of God, our tongues have a lot of power. And tonight, Pastor Pam, we want to use that power with our words to express our love and admiration for your 60 years of life. Please direct your attention to the screen and hear and receive the 60 reasons why.
Diplomatic.
Driven.
Funny.
Accountable.
Strong.
Motivated.
Friend.
Virtuous.
Wife.
Kind.
Mother.
Bright.
Well-spoken.
Creative.
Divine.
Hardworking.
Tough.
Graceful.
Powerful.
Disciplined.
Aunt.
Superb.
Incredible.
Showstopper.
Steadfast.
Ladylike.
Elegant.
Passionate.
Merciful.
Patience.
Educated.
Sincere.
Resourceful.
Professional.
Stunning.
Pastor.
Caring.
Devoted.
Genuine.
Godmother.
Loving.
Ambitious.
Angelic.
Respected.
Beautiful.
Mesmerizing.
Kind-hearted.
Sister.
Grandmother.
Influential.
Lovable.
Trustworthy.
Anointed.
Classy.
Glamorous.
Entrepreneur.
Pamela grew up well-versed in business, as her mom and dad had several businesses. Her dad owned Blue Gardenia, his bar, Wes's Place, Doll's Chatterbox, Flipside Records, and Hazel's Diner. She enjoyed spending time at the record store playing all her favorite tunes. Seeing her mom work and go on to own 12 real estate properties with her dad, along with being a beautician, she wouldn't fall shy of having a keen sense of entrepreneurship and a desire to own her own businesses. Little did she know, God had the perfect business in store for her.
Perfect Peace is a skincare line that was designed to empower women to rest, to relax, to be restored, to be rejuvenated, to pamper themselves. It's like having a spa experience and never leaving home. Perfect Peace, you know, just the name alone, you can't live without it. I love empowering women
And the way that I love to empower them is not only tell them what they should do, but supply the tools that they need to get it done. I know that you've tried many products. There are many products on the line, but once you try Perfect Peace, you will have a spa experience without ever leaving home. You'll never go back to what you're using, because Perfect Peace not only allows you to smell the aroma and to be uplifted, but it's what everybody needs. And everybody wants Perfect Peace. And it's something that the Lord promised us in the Bible. He said, I will keep you in perfect peace if you keep your mind stayed on me. My peace I give you, and that peace I leave with you. So it's something that belongs to us. All we have to do is accept it and walk in it.
Perfect Peace is continuing to create a spa experience in homes all across our nation. Expansions are taking place, new products are being developed. Perfect Peace just launched its first scented candle. Pamela Hines, we celebrate your 60 years of life, your legacy, and your amazing accomplishments. Countless lives have been inspired and courses have been changed because of the yes you gave to God in following your passion. Happy birthday, Pastor Pam. May God bless you with many more purpose-filled years to come.
Pastor Pam, you've been a friend to so many of us. I think about the day that you came and you found me. At one of the lowest points of my life, we just want to let you know, thank you for being a friend.
Hold my hand. that's what she is. She is my wife. And I am so glad to be here tonight to see all of the people who speak well of my wife and to say those wonderful things. And they're not made up, they're not coached. Everyone has the same theme from the first to the end. If you know her, you know that she is that and much more. One thing that you all don't know about her that I know, and I've known this from the very beginning, that she is gonna be with me until she go to be with Jesus. I want y'all to know that. I ain't playing about that. She can only be with two people, me and Jesus. And she can stay with me or I can send her to Jesus. Woo, Lord have mercy. No, y'all stop, because I'm not trying to get in no trouble or nothing. I just say that, cause it's the truth. I am so blessed to be the husband of Pamela Hines. And there's a story, I won't tell you all about it, but I'll just say this. I thank God for my mama, who told me that if I didn't marry Pam, she told me she was gonna disown me, she was gonna make me move to another part of the country, and she never wanted to see me again as long as she lived. She said, now call that other lady and tell her that you ain't gonna see her no more. I said, call her. So I called her, I said, my mama said, I can't see you no more. She said, your mama said? I said, yeah. She said, well, you sure can't see me no more if your mama had to tell you. But that was the greatest blessing in my life. I almost missed my life's blessing. And that is my wife. She and Jesus are the best two things that have ever happened to me. And there are people who love Pastor Pam. And if you are watching and you have not yet turned off, because we're taking this time for a reason. We only have one day to get it right, and that's today. We won't be celebrating her birthday tomorrow. We may be celebrating the fact that she is here, but we won't be celebrating her birthday. We're doing that now. So I encourage you, if you've not yet released a seed of love to her, do that. It's going to be a blessing to you. And I know this is the truth because the Bible is right. And God said it in his word that it is the right thing to do because they are worthy of double honor. And I appreciate those of you that are here tonight, all of those that came out in this cold weather. We would to God that this whole event of this pandemic wasn't here, but it is here. But thank you for being here in the midst of it. There's a very special person who, if we weren't under these circumstances, then you know this place would be filled with people if we weren't under these circumstances. But they still wanted to express their love to Pastor Pam and let her know that she is very special and she's a dear part of their life. At this time, a very special person who I believe is one of the top psalmists in the world. She's going to minister and just come and bless us at this time. None other than my wife's most close friend and the person who my wife has wanted to hear sing over me at any time, and that's Kim Burrell.
Pastor Pam, happy 60th birthday, and every day is getting sweeter. Hey! Love you so much. Happy birthday, sweet lady. You can say this. Today is another day. New mercies I see. Lord, I'm in your hands. I know you'll come for me. It's a little rough at times. Don't know what to do. But Lord, I know you will help me make it through. Every day, oh yeah, it's gonna get sweeter, sweeter than the day before. Every day is sweeter. I'm learning how to love him more. Oh, yeah, sweeter, sweeter than the day before. Every day is sweeter. Maybe you can say, I'm waiting for the sun to shine because I'm. My joy is coming in the morning time. Oh, now that my eyes do see, I know that you really love me. Before I get to know ya, I find out that you're so good for me. You've been so good to me. Oh, every day, sweeter, sweeter than the day before. Every day is sweeter. I'm learning how to love you more and more and more and more and more.
the day before. Every day is sweeter. Age ain't nothing but another number. Every day is getting sweeter. Learning how to love him more, and we'll do everything to learn the more of him, to make it sweeter. Hey, you're good on a Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and someday you'll find out it's getting sweeter. Listen, every day make you wanna add another day into your week, because he gets so sweet. Yeah, you're good on a Monday. Hey, hey, every day gets sweeter. Yeah, oh, you're good on a Monday, Tuesday. Hey, yeah. Day. Every day will get sweeter.
Thank you so much, Kim. Wow, she's the singingest woman I know other than Kateri. Let me say this. If you are here tonight and you want to release your gifts, you can stay right at your seat. We have people who will serve you and will come and receive from you. So all you have to do is just lift them up, and while you're doing that, they will come. If you notice, we did this a little unconventional. We didn't have that time. We just stopped in this celebration and asked you to give, but we've been encouraging you throughout the whole celebration to release your gifts and to be a blessing to Pastor Pam. And speaking of Pastor Pam, it is so good to know that the person that you are blessing is worthy. The person that you're blessing is not one way in your presence and another way out of your presence, but she is consistently who she is at all time. And I can say this as her husband for over 41 years, close to 42 years. Anything that she puts her hand to, anything that she embraces, when she's finished with it, it's going to be better. She puts her heart and her soul into what she does. She never does anything half-hearted. She does everything with everything that's in her, because she wants to give her best at all times. When she cooks for me, it gives me life. I tell her all the time, I can wait a whole week to eat a meal from you because I know it'll sustain me until you do it again. I never put pressure on her to be more than what she is, but I always allow her to be everything that God has called her to be. I never want to interfere with the woman of God that's a pastor. I never want to distract the one who's a businesswoman. I never want to compete with the mother, and I never want to take her away from her grandchildren. I want her to be completely everything that God has called her to be, and my wife also. I am so privileged to have this woman in my life, and you see me for who I am because who God has brought beside me. Let us take this time to celebrate and welcome the woman that we celebrate tonight, Pastor Pam, as she comes to embrace us and to give us words. And then we have one more presentation.
Wow. Thank you. My heart is so full on tonight. I really appreciate everything that has been done. I am so happy to hear your love. I appreciate your expression. You know, my heart is always to be the very best that I can and to treat people the way I want to be treated. And to just sit here and hear how you've been blessed, it blesses me. I thank God for everybody that had words. I won't start to name, but I appreciate you. I love you, and I thank you for everybody that's watching. I know that if this was my funeral, that the will of God is being done in my life, because I want to be the very best that I can be. I thank God for my husband. He has given me an opportunity to minister to people literally all over the world. So being his wife is such a blessing. And I don't fix food. That's much. Right.
every now and then.
I really try to cook his food. Last week, we had a really funny experience. I haven't opened up a can of corn in 30 years. And I opened up a can of corn because I was in a hurry. You know, they said stock up because of COVID. So I bought some canned goods, and I ran out of fresh vegetables. So I opened a can, and I fixed it. And my husband said, honey, I think I might have COVID because I can't taste this corn. He said, what did you do? What did you do different? I said, I didn't do anything. I put the butter, you know, the salt and all. I didn't fry it like I normally do. He said, I can't taste it. Come taste it. And I said, well, you know it is canned corn. He said, that's why I can't taste it. You're going to make me think I got the COVID. I normally prepare food. I don't fix it, but I did fix something last week. And I will continue to go to the store, cut the corn off the cob, shuck it, put it in the butter, fry it, salt, pepper, you know, all that good stuff. Honey, I promise you, I ain't gonna fix you no more food.
I appreciate it.
I'm gonna cook it if I have to heat the oven up on 350 for 2 weeks. I'm gonna continue. I love you all so much. Thank you for making me feel happy, making me feel joyful, making me cry and making me laugh. I love you so very much, and thank you in advance for every gift. I appreciate you all. God bless you.
You came out tonight in the cold, and we want to let you go now. Thank you again. My voice is a little raspy. I preached hard today, or I would have sang for her, but I'll do that when we get home tonight.
You promise?
I promise you.
Okay, just so y'all know, when he make real
big... All right. I want you all to know that we appreciate you. If you have any gifts that you have not yet released, take the time now to do so. We're going to dismiss you. I want to pray with you, and I want to pray for you. We really do love Pastor Pam, and under the circumstances, those who put forth an effort to make this evening happen, I want to thank you for working behind the scenes. You've done a wonderful, tremendous job. It's absolutely beautiful, like elegant, and we have to learn how to understand the categories of. We never expect for God to just slay people when we're talking about people. That happens when we talk about God. But we can take a pause and appreciate who God has blessed us with. And guess what? He doesn't mind. He encourages it. Show love to those who labor among you. Honor them and continue to be a blessing. I'm going to pray, and then they're going to close out with our with the praise dancers and the band. And for all of the singers, thank you so much, all the work that you've done. Father, I thank you and I praise you tonight for this glamorous, wonderful evening, for the MCs, those who have made the sacrifice to come out tonight, and those who wanted to be here but they just could not come. Bishop and Pastor Deborah, who traveled from Illinois to be here, Pastor Melba, and to all of those who are in the room. So many expressed wanting to come, but they send their love. Now I pray, God, for every gift that has been released, that you increase those 100-fold, and that you allow the love that they've shown and expressed tonight to be shown to them in a double-fold manner. For those who are listening, all the preachers and the pastors and the people who have sent in seed to bless Pastor Pam, I thank you for the increase that will come into their lives as a result of their kindness and their giving. And now as we prepare to leave this room, but never your presence, go with us and protect us, keep us under the center of your will, and keep us from harm and danger. I thank you for a safe trip home. Thank you for no freak incidents, accidents, dangers, seen or unseen. When it's all said and done, you get the glory, the honor, and praise belongs to you. In the name of Christ Jesus, I pray. And let every heart say, amen. Our praise dancers and the
special
praise
shout out to my grandchildren. You make my heart go.